Ever since the Congress Party was routed in the 1967 elections to the Tamil Nadu Assembly, it has had very little say in the state. The party has become an insignificant player, to say the least, and is left to piggyback on the two Dravidian parties in one election after another over the last 5 decades. With factional feuds and infighting becoming an inseparable part of the party organization, a revival is highly unlikely in the near future. The growing number of factions and the reluctance of the central leadership in setting things right have worsened its plight over the decades. The party leadership seems to be very less worried about its plummeting vote share, around 15% in 1991 to less than 7% in 2016. The party's performance has been dismal in 2011, 2014 and 2016, with only the 2019 general elections being a face-saving measure. The Congress has been contesting the assembly polls as part of an alliance led by the Dravida Munnetra Kazhagam or the All India Dravida Munnetra Kazhagam since 1971 except 1989. Its dependence on the Dravidian giants have only eroded the party's base in many of its strongholds. Vijay Shankar, the editor of Frontline, speaks in this regard.
Congress again, 67 after they lost the elections, one section of Congress was with, there is stronger section, no? After Congress split at the All India level, the faction led by Kamaraj was very strong. Actually, in Dindigul election, when MGR formed ADMK, this Congress O was a major force. And later, Kamaraj died in 1973 when the emergency was on. So Congress was a strong party. He had a good following, even youth. He was a kind of idealistic youth. No? They were all Kamaraj followers. Later, when Janata Party was formed, when Congress was also merged into Janata Party, even then, that faction was very strong. It was led by one Pa Ramachandran. But what really happened immediately after emergency was, Kamaraj opposed emergency. He was very, he regretted it. It seems he even shed tears. Karunanidhi writes in his biography that Kamaraj was so upset about the emergency. But what really happened to the Congress was, Mr. Mupanar, G.K. Mupanar, who was with Kamaraj throughout, he came out and he joined, he said Kamaraj in his last days, which was not true, in his last days, he wanted to be with the Congress led by Indira Gandhi. So he led a major faction out of this Congress and only one group remained as Janata Party. Later, because of not, they didn't have many prominent leaders. Slowly, Janata Party in Tamil Nadu became very weak. So whatever strength Congress had was what it inherited from what Mupanar took away. And Mupanar, because of his other skills, no, in managing the party, in settling party disputes, that kind of thing. No, he was a kind of he was not a kingmaker, but inside he used to be a very good coordinator. Like that, no? So that only that Congress exists. But the biggest Congress problem is they never allowed any. Like any other part of India, Congress never allowed any leader to grow in stature. So I used to say that Congress in Tamil Nadu has an inbuilt opposition. There'll be 10 leaders and there are 11 groups. And even recently, after this seat sharing exercise, finally seats were finalized in in their office, Satyamurthy Bhavan. Two factions held, it's not a demonstration, one faction went on a fast, Unnavirtham, hunger strike. The other faction opposed it, they were also on hunger strike. And there were scenes. Actually, Congress office in Tamil Nadu is known for that. Big fights, no? Inside, openly, open fight. So again, Congress, the real problem of the Congress, which is the problem in many other areas in Tamil Nadu, there is no one strong leader. There are lots of factions. They never come together. They never see eye to eye. So it's going to be very difficult, and they lost the game long back. They lost the game long back. And DMK and ADMK, what really happened was DMK split. Actually, what has happened is because of DMK split, Dravidian movement became very strong. Because one faction became the counterfoil, no, for DMK. ADMK and DMK, they shared power. So Dravidian dominance continued, and Congress was never able to break this at all. Completely unimaginative, and they could not remember because they again DMK, ADMK broke away, and MGR was a powerful leader, and that thing was inherited by Jayalalitha. So there was no space for another front. Yeah, Congress at least had some 20%, 25% voted at the time of emergency. Now it has come down to maybe less than 10%. So Congress definitely is going to be very difficult, and there is no leadership and there is no program. Congress overall program, there is no program or alternative program. No, all over India we face this problem. So Congress can be, the only problem is Congress has presence in a lot of villages everywhere. Some old timers, the youngsters are not with Congress, most of them. So only problem is organizationally they are present. At the time of elections, maybe some 3-5% vote will help in any alliance, in any tight contest. That way, the relevance remains. And because still it remains an All India Party, so these parties still take Congress help at the time of elections.
The Congress Party has a lot to prove in the Tamil Nadu Assembly elections, with its diminishing influence reflecting on the number of seats it contests and wins. Rahul Gandhi made multiple visits to the state, apparently to increase the bargaining capacity, but the party had to contend with 25 seats in the assembly elections. With a waning influence and increasing infighting, the party relies highly on the strength of the alliance parties to win a handy number of seats.